In this video, we will begin with solid primitive in 3D drawing of AutoCAD. Solid primitives are predefined shape in AutoCAD, which we can make drawing using any of 3D geometry. So you will see solid primitive icon on this bar in the left corner of home tab. When you click this flyout, you will be able to see the list of solid primitive options that are available in AutoCAD. So we are going to look at all the options listed here. Now make sure all the 3D axes are shown here, such as X, Y, and Z. If you can't see this, go to panel right on top of this coordinate and change the setting, or you can press home key from this view queue. Let's start with the first option. Click this flyout, choose box. As you can see at prompt line, it is asking to specify corner point and click second point. Now as you can see, our box is moving vertical or Z direction, so that we give height. Click anywhere on top, or you can specify the height if required in the drawing. You can also change the view frame style. Just click here right beside custom view, change to 2D wireframe. Now press Ctrl Z to go back to our original shape, which is shaded. Next we have cylinder, but before that we can specify the dimension of the box while drawing. Click the box once again, specify first point, then add the dimensions you want. For example, length 8 unit, width 5 unit, and height 2 unit, and press enter. So here you have your box with known dimensions. Let's go to cylinder option, specify the center point. Now at prompt, it is asking to enter the radius, say 2, press enter, and give height of 6, and press enter. So this is the cylinder, although you may not able to see this as cylinder, but it is in 2D wireframe vision style. So you can change this vision style to shaded or some other style to make it more clear. Next we have cone. Again we need to specify a base radius, say 3 units, and press enter. Give the height of 10 and press enter. Next let's look sphere. Select it, click on the screen, and give radius. Let's say I want 2 as radius, press enter. So here we have sphere. Next we have pyramid. Select it to activate the command, specify first point. As you can see here at prompt, it is asking to specify a base radius or inscribed. This means that the cursor is aligned to the center point or midpoint. Then you can type the height you want. Second option in this pyramid is that when you specify first point, you will have another option at command prompt, that is by clicking inscribed pattern, another style will be available, which is subscribed. This means our pyramid will be made in such a way that this square is completely enclosed within a circle, and the diameter of this circle will be equal to the distance between two opposite corners of this square. Then give height. We can also give different style for the cone. Select cone from this flyout, choose cone. Specify a point on the screen, then give radius say 3, as we have done to the other cone. Now from here we give different style. We will select top radius, say I want 1 unit, and press enter. Then specify the height. As you can see, the difference between the two cones. One has only 1 radius at the bottom and top end is sharp pointed, while this cone top radius is provided. So next we have wedge option. Select it, specify first corner of wedge rectangle. After that, our wedge is formed along y-axis. As you can see here, from y-axis our wedge is moving upward, or you can also move downward along y-axis. Let's click here or enter the height. You can also give direct wedge, so select the option, then click at a point, then choose cube style or type C at command prompt and press enter. As you can see here, wedge is automatically created. The last option is Taurus. Select the option, specify the center point, give radius of 3, press enter. Now it's prompting you to give another radius for the tube. Say I want it to be 1 unit. Make sure the radius for the tube is less so that the tube is visible. So here we have all these solid primitives, and they can be drawn without the help of any 2D geometry. This was all about solid primitive of 3D AutoCAD.